is in this, we are going to see loops in PHP. So in general, we have some 4 or 5 loops. We are going to see one by one. That is while loop, do while, and then while do, here, and one more for loops and for each loops. So what is the need for a loop? There are some times when we need particular statements to be executed again and again based on some conditions. In that case, if you write the statement again and again, say for example, a particular statement wants to be executed for 5 times, means if you write that code, single line code, 5 times, it is waste. Okay, waste of the space, everything is waste. So instead, you put it in a code saying that it has to be executed for 5 times, then it will be executed. So you can give a condition. So when it reaches the count 5, the printing stops, or whatever it is doing, it will be stopped. So loops are used for executing statements which are repeated for certain period or certain time based on a condition. Okay. So here, so each time the code executes inside a loop, it is called iteration. So how it will get executed? As we have already seen, as I have told you, that it has to be repeated for a particular time. So how many times? That has to be decided by the condition statement. So if you write a loop, there are 3 basic things in any loop. First, initialization. So for example, 5 times it has to be executed means first initialization is number 1. So that has to be initialized. Then condition has to be given. Say if the count reaches, initially we are initializing the count to be 1. Then when the count reaches 5, till it reaches 5, the information inside the code inside the loop has to be executed continuously. So when it reaches the count of 5, then it has to come out. Okay, so that is the condition. So how the loop will proceed? Either by incrementing or decrementing the count. Initially the count is 1 means now it will be executed 1. Now the count has to be incremented to 2. Now the while loop, the loop executes 3, now again incremented, and so on. So it has to, when it reaches 5, then it will come out. So you have to make the loop towards coming to an end. So if any loop consists of these 3 properties compulsorily. First, initialization of the loop variable is done. You will be using a loop variable, because using that loop variable only, you have to it will be decided whether the loop, the execution inside, execution of the code inside has to be stopped or continued. So a loop variable is done. So first, initialization is done. Then secondly, when to stop looping based on loop. Loop condition is defined, just like the comparison in an if statement. Third, the loop variable is incremented or decremented in order to make the loop fail. So it comes out and executes the statement next to the end of the loop. So these are the basic rules of any loop. So now let us see an example of the while loop. While loop has the following syntax. While, then you have to, within bracket, you will be giving the expression, that is conditional expression. Then code to be executed will be given within the open and curly braces. It can be any valid PHP code. It is not a single code. More than one code can come inside a while loop. Same way in all the loops, how many number of statements you want to execute it repeated again and again, all those statements you can put it here, provided the condition is true. So when it becomes, when the condition given here false, the loop will be over and the line next to that loop will be executed. For example, let us say this small program where it counts to 10. Initially we are initializing a variable called $num, which is equal to 1. So this is called initialization. So this is a loop variable. When you are using this as a inside a while loop, then you call this as a loop variable. So this you are checking whether it is less than or equal to 10. Since it is equal to 1, it is less than or equal to 10. Yes, it is true. So when it is true, it go inside. Now the statement will be executed. Now what is the statement? We are printing some value. So the number is $num. We print that value as 1. Now, if you don't give this num plus plus, what will happen? The loop will never become greater than, or it will never become greater than 10. So what happens? It always true. It never become false. The while loop never comes out. So it will lead to an indefinite loop. That is why inside the loop, we have to make the loop variable either decrement, increment, depending upon this condition, so that it reaches this conditions and it becomes false, and so that only it can come out of the while loop. So that is what we have to do. So if you see this output, see here, first initially num equal to 1, then this value is, since it is, it will check, since the value 1 is less than or equal to 10, it is less than. So what happened? If this value is printed, num is 1. Then the num is incremented, value inside this. So now it becomes 2. Value in num is 2. So it checks. Still 2 is less than 10, and so on. So when it becomes 10, it is equal to 10. So that also it will be printed. See here. Then it go inside. Now it is incremented to 11. So here it checks. It is not equal to, it is not less than as well as it is not equal to 10. So now it breaks and it comes out of the while loop and gives the value done. So this is how it executes. Now we'll see do while loop. Here what we have seen is while, here itself, while entering the loop itself, the checking is done. Okay. So if it is, it add hard. So for example, first itself, if it is 11, if we are initializing this to 11, then it here it checks. 11 is less than or equal to 10. No. So this statements will not be executed. Automatically it comes here and execute print none. So this condition is checked here, first itself. So if it is true only, it will allow. Whereas in do while loop, first condition is at the end. So do, then curly braces, the code to execute. Here you are giving the expression. So for example, we'll see this example, the same program. Num equal to 1 initialized, then do, echo number is, we are printing that number, then loop variable increment. Then we have given checking. So what happens if you see this program, execution of this program, first it will print 1, then increment. So it executes, okay, without checking here. Here there is no checking. So at the end of the loop only, when the first iteration is over only, it will check. So if you see this output, it is similar to this here. It will be similar to the loop execution is similar. Whereas if you have given num equal to 11, then what happens? It will print that value. See, like this. It will print that because of this echo, it will print. Here only we increment. Now it checks. Here it has become 12. Whether it is 11 or 12, whatever it is, here only it becomes fail. So what happened? Now it comes out. Anyway, it will be printed one time. So that is the main difference. So the loop always execute at least once in the do loop. Whereas in while, first itself it checks, and if it satisfies only, it allows the loop to be executed. That is the difference between the while loop and do loop. So you have to give the conditions properly. It is left to the developer to use it according to his needs. Now we go to for loop, another type of loop. Here, in for loop, the initialization, testing of expression, that is conditional, and then increment or decrement. All those things in are a single line. See here, it's like that. Num equal to 1. It is not done outside. Whereas in do loop, we are doing it the initialization outside. Here it is done here itself. So the syntax is for open bracket. Here itself initialization is given, semicolon. Then the condition is given here, semicolon. Then the increment, loop variable, increment or decrement. That is done here. Now, Now we print the statement. So here only the there is no increment decrement here again. You should not do that. The loop variable increment decrement should not be done here. It has to be done in this only. So modification should not be done inside the loop. So if you see that output, you will have this as the output. So now what we have seen the three loops. Suppose you are executing the loop for 100 times. So some when it reaches some particular point, you may want to break the loop. So how to break a loop? Emergency, it's like a emergency stop button. So how to do that? So let us see this example. Counter equal to minus 3. We have given the counter equal to minus 3. Now, since we have initialization of a for loop can be done outside, but increment or decrement should not be done here. And the checking, that is conditional checking and increment decrement should be done here itself. It should not be done here. Only the initialization you can do it outside. Or you can do write this statement here also, both are equal. So let us say counter equal to minus 3. And then so here we have given, since it is already done, here you should not, here we are not doing it initialization again. Already we have done the counter increment, counter initialization here. Now counter is less than 10, counter plus plus. So till that it will be processed. Initial value is minus 3. Okay. Now counter equal to 0. So when it is 0, it has to break, because we don't want to do a division by 0. Because the program in this, what we do is 100 divided by this counter value. So when counter value becomes 0, we want to avoid division by 0. Stopping to avoid division by 0. So after that we give a break. So that we put it in a if class and we break. Now what happens? Initially it is minus 3. So that is printed. Echo 100 by this statement is printed. Because all are in for loop. Minus 3. Then according to this statement, counter plus plus, minus 3 becomes minus 2. And then minus 1. Then when it reaches 0, after minus 1, it reaches 0. So in that case, what happens? If counter equal to 0, this checking will be done. So if counter equal to 0, then it prints this, echo this message. And because of this break, it comes out of the for loop itself. The further counter counting will not take place. Because after 0, it can count to 1. Because the condition is given less than 10. So that will not be done. Immediately, it comes out of the for loop. But sometimes we may not want to skip the other counts. Say for example, here when it becomes 0, immediately it comes out. But I want to skip only this 0. Okay. But I want to print when it is 1, 2, 3, 4. So till 9, I want to print the other values also. So how to do that? Say for example, like this. I want to skip only 0. All the other things I want to display. So in that case, you can go for continue statement. So for example, here, the same thing you can give, instead of break, you can give continue. The same program. Here it is initialized and here it is given 10. Condition is given less than 10, counter plus plus. Now if it is equal to 0, we have to skip that 0. So continue. What happens? It will not print this. Whatever is given here, it will not print. All the statements after this continue will not be printed for this alone. But that 0 is skipped and it will go to the next one. Okay, so what is that 0 after 0? Because of this counter plus plus, it becomes 1. So now it checks whether 1 is less than 10. Yes, now here it checks it is not equal to 0. So this thing will not get executed. Here this thing will get executed. Echo will get executed. So 100 by $1, that is 100 by count 1. So that is what we are seeing in this program. So continue is used to skip a particular thing and continue the rest of the loop, whereas break, immediately whenever the condition comes, immediately it comes out of the loop.